The RNC is holding their little gathering. We will likely know today who the next leader of the Republican Party is going to be with the RNC. Probably going to be Ronna McDaniel, which means the Republicans can look forward to more years of losing. Actually, no matter who they pick, they can probably look forward to that because all their options are pretty much terrible. But you've got 168 voting members of the RNC all together right now. And believe it or not, folks, the New York Times actually reached out to every single one of those people, all 168 members, and they asked every single one of them, are you endorsing Donald Trump for president for 2024? Out of 168, four said, yes, I endorse Donald Trump. The other 164 said, I'm not ready to make that decision yet. But it actually gets so much worse than that. And by the way, that's like a 2.3% of the RNC that actually has endorsed Trump now. The statements that some of these voting members of the RNC made to the New York Times about Donald Trump are absolutely mind-blowing. And they paint a picture of a political party that wants nothing to do with him as they move forward. So let me read these quotes. This isn't 2016. People have moved on. That's from Kentucky National Committee member Mac Brown. Arkansas member Jonathan Barnett said, I've been a supporter of Donald Trump in the past. I just think we need choices this time. We've got to look at all of our options. Then you have Art Wittich, RNC member from Montana, who said, quote, everybody is very appreciative of Trump, and he did a lot of great things. There's this burning desire to win in 2024, and that's what's going to drive a lot of the action. So you got Mr. Wittich over here saying, like, yeah, we actually want to win in 2024, so, you know, probably don't want him. Then you have John Hammond, RNC member from Indiana, who said, quote, to win 50% plus one in the Electoral College requires us to find an alternative, and I think we've got plenty of good choices. We can't be a cult of personality any longer. Then you have Oscar Brock, RNC member from Tennessee. I supported Donald Trump in 2016 and 2020, but it is clearly time for the Republican Party to move on from Donald Trump. I know many of you feel the same way I do. There's more, by the way. I'm not going to read anymore because I think you get the point. The members of the RNC, the people that are actually steering the political party, well, they're supposed to be steering the political party. They want nothing to do with him. You know, they're trying to act, you know, cordial about it. Like, hey, I loved you, man. You were great. You did some awesome things. Why don't you sit this one out, though, bud? Like, we got a lot of cool people over here. We want to go talk to these folks. So if you could just like, yeah, I mean, you know where the door is. If you could just go. We love you. Thank you so much. But you can't win. You're not a winner. You're a loser. We've moved on. The people have moved on. Now, the only problem that the RNC has is that, unfortunately, the polls are showing the people, the voting members of the Republican Party, you know, the public, they haven't. Donald Trump is still your front runner. His approval rating has actually gone up. That's probably going to change once he starts doing these rallies and reminds people of how terrible he is, which is probably going to piss off even more RNC members. But at the end of the day, your party still likes him. The voters still choose him over the other folks. It's going to change. But right now, you've got a very serious problem because, yeah, you're right. Trump can't win nationally. I don't care what the polls right now are saying. He can't. But he can damn sure win a primary, which will guarantee Republicans a loss in 2024. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.